this video, I would talk about how you can find electric field due to linear distribution of charges or line charge. For this, first consider a long, thin, uniformly charged wire with lambda charge per unit length, and our problem is to find electric field intensity due to this wire at perpendicular distance from the wire. Now, if this wire is very long and we are at points far away from both the ends, then by symmetry, the field lines outside the wire are radial and lies in planes perpendicular to the wire. Also, the field has same magnitude at all points at same radial distance from the wire. Here in this case, electric field at any point cannot have any component parallel to the wire, because any axial component from charges on one side would be accompanied by an equal axial component from charges on the other side. We will now try to find electric field at a point P, which is at a distance r from the uniformly charged wire. So we can assume Gaussian surface to be a right circular cylinder of radius r and length l, with its ends perpendicular to the wire as shown in this figure. Now, lambda is charge per unit length on the wire, and as can be seen in this figure, direction of electric field E is perpendicular to the wire, and components of electric field E normal to end faces of cylinder makes no contribution to the electric flux. So from Gauss's law, integral E dot dA is equal to charge enclosed upon epsilon naught. Now considering left hand side of this equation, integral E dot dA is equal to E integral dA. As electric field E is constant at all points on curved surface. Now surface area of cylinder of radius r and length l is given by A is equal to 2 pi r l. So integral E dot dA is equals to E into 2 pi r l. Now charge enclosed in cylinder is equal to linear charge density times length l of the cylinder. So charge enclosed is equals to lambda l. Now from Gauss's law, integral E dot dA is equals to Q enclosed upon epsilon naught, or E into 2 pi r l is equals to lambda l upon epsilon naught. Or we can say that electric field E is equals to lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught r. So here we see that electric field E is proportional to lambda by r. So we can conclude that electric field intensity of a long charge wire does not depend on the length of the wire, but on the radial distance r of points from the wire. For more notes and study material regarding this topic, you can visit our website, that is physicscatalyst.com.